I love the original Dishonored. So when the second game reporting having performance issues on high-end systems, I got worried. However, after some careful experimentation, it turns out that, for the moment, there are at least a couple of small tweaks you can use to disable some extra fluff and get lower than low graphics on this game. Welcome to the Low Spec Gamer. On this weird channel, I find ways of getting games to run on lower-end computers. And on this episode, you can forget about fog or post effects, because we're making Dishonored 2 run. Oh, Dishonored 2. A 2016 game that might as well ignore minimal requirements because it does not perform very well on most systems. Because of this, I'm going to use the GTX 460. This was a mid-end GPU back when it was released, and it is actually one of the stronger old GPUs I have used on this channel, and that is how you know this game's going to be trouble. And on the CPU department, I'll be using the reliable Intel Celeron G1840. You might have noticed this game is running in something called the Void Engine, which is very different from the Unreal Engine from the previous game. However, turns out Void is a modified ID Tech 5, the same engine used by Wolfenstein The New Order, although a lot of it was rewritten. This time there is no way to experiment with a dev console, which makes our work particularly hard, but some of the old tricks still create visible changes. We're going to start with all the settings to the lowest, and yes, this time I will leave dynamic resolution on in manual, since it will help a lot with some of the heaviest moments. You will see its effects soon. First, I need to mention that the game is very flexible regarding resolution. If you add a custom low resolution on your GPU's control panel, it will show up in the game for you to select. And now for the really interesting stuff. You can add a couple of interesting commands as launch options for the game on Steam. If you do not have Steam, you will find a link in the description explaining how to do that using shortcuts. This command over here disables a number of post-processing effects. You will particularly notice the difference as harsher lighting. A lot of the game's elements will look overly bright. This other one disables fog. Fog is used quite extensively for effect in this game, particularly to hide elements in the distance, so a lot of low poly background will be visible. But you might get a small improvement from not having to render it at all. Both commands are in the description. With those small changes, I set out to see what kind of experience this game could now offer.
Game looks so shiny this way. It's interesting to think how I have created a particularly bottlenecked system for this experiment that I'm doing right now. Sometimes the FPS is limited by the slow dual-core CPU, and sometimes it's just limited by the GPU. Yep. I think the only thing that is not bottlenecked about the system is the RAM, at least for this game. You can see the dynamic resolution sort of kicking in. Like, this is normal resolution, and then this, see the building in normal resolution? And then, when you turn it to this corner, it all goes to shit and drops the resolution. Oh shit, I was in. Oh, I got them fighting, that was unexpected. Unuseful. Maybe I can make them kill each other. So that power that I just used, yep, that worked perfectly! I managed to kill them both! And now the fight keeps happening, and now maybe, oh, it's, they're running away. Nope, not from my watch. Kapam! Yep, I'm a master of stealth. The game might have some performance issues, but I gotta admit, that dynamic resolution scaling thing actually does a fairly good job. Well, that works. Nope. Thank you.
Clapper soldiers, there's an interloper in my home.
Oh dear. Oh dear, and I have used my last grenade. This is not good. Well, what's up? Oh god. This is going to be more of a test of performance than actual combat. Ah! Okay. Oh god. That did not went as well as I expected. Okay, now's my opportunity. There you go. Okay, that's not good. Yeah, that door sure did stop! My bullets, they do nothing! Ah! Hit the tank! Ah! Well then. Indeed. Look at all those poorly illuminated houses, and that one at the bottom that's just failing to render correctly. Another interesting tidbit is that you can use these tools to make the soldiers fight for you. So I can get this machine to fight the other machine there. Wow. Okay, there. And hopefully clear my path. Let's just try to get his attention. Hey, over here. And now, let them fight! Well, that was short. They're his, and he only has one soldier with him. Actually, this might be easier, because he's alone.
Goodbye, Grand Inventor.
Well, that went better than I expected.
That is almost all for this video. Let me just extend my thanks to those who have been participating in the contest in the Discord and making fan art or funny pictures. I'm really loving the stuff some of you are coming up with, so please, by all means, continue. Thank you to the people in Patreon as well. See you all soon, everybody.